Fancy pants features and fiery performance be damned. The Yaris and its subcompact compatriots prioritize affordability and practicality. But other than being budget-friendly, these economy cars are not all created equal. The Toyota has the best standard active safety features in its class, but subpar highway fuel economy and cargo space. Its wimpy four-cylinder engine and outdated transmissions deliver lethargic acceleration. At least its compliant chassis provides a comfortable ride and nimble handling. While this nut attaches few strengths and several flaws, there are worse things to drive. High's cheap transportation, respectable ride and handling, standard active safety features. Low's below average powertrains, below average highway fuel economy, below average cargo storage. Verdict: not the best subcompact hatchback you can buy, but not the worst. What's new for 2018? Following a mid-cycle refresh for 2015, Toyota tweaks the Yaris again for 2018. The front end receives new headlight and grille designs, L-inlay trims wear chrome accents, and the sporty say sports a piano black mesh grille and trim specific lighting elements. The revised rear end has wider taillights and a lower bumper, too. The interior is mostly unchanged, but L-inlay models now feature an updated instrument panel with an LCD display that was previously exclusive to the say. A backup camera and audio controls on the steering wheel are also newly standard. Trims and options: we'd choose the Yaris hatchback as the cheapest new Toyota money can buy, undercutting the splendid Yaris Yaris sedan by a few hundred dollars. It's available with a 5-speed manual or a 4-speed automatic transmission, 2 or 4 doors, and 3 trim levels L, Le, and Say. Among these configurations, the Le is available only with an automatic transmission, and the Say is only sold as a 4-door. While we like the value of the L, the 4-door version only comes with the archaic automatic, which should be avoided at all costs. That leaves the top tier Say, with exclusive standard features such as a 7.0-inch touchscreen infotainment system with Sirius XM satellite radio and real-time weather and traffic, LED headlight accents and fog lights, leather-trimmed steering wheel and shift knob, 16-inch wheels with dark accents. Apart from the handful of available accessories, the lone options on the Say are the automatic transmission for $800 and 2-tone paint options. We prefer the standard manual gearbox and one color, which means our Say stick is at $19,155. While subcompacts are expected to be affordable and not powerful, the Yaris sinks below the surface of acceptable powertrain operation. Its 106 horsepower 1.5-liter inline and standard 5-speed manual transmission or optional 4-speed automatic are older, slower, and louder than most classmates. Apart from its ability to transport people and property, aka being a car, the Yaris's powertrains turn acceleration and refinement into afterthoughts. Our test car was equipped with the 5-speed manual, one gear short of similar rivals. It took 9.1 seconds to saunter from 0 to 60 miles per hour, trailing the high-end i-Accent by 1.6 seconds. At least the stick-shift Yaris outgunned the last version we tested with the old-fashioned 4-speed automatic, which needed 10.2 seconds to reach 60 miles per hour. Passing on the highway required a heavy right foot and enduring incessant engine noise. Thankfully, the Yaris was less raucous around town. The manual transmission was also easy to operate, despite long throws and uneven clutch tick-up. While the government estimates small gaps between these small cars, our real-world observations revealed the Toyota's surprisingly low highway fuel economy and range. Behold the advantage of the manual transmission. The stick-shifted Yaris was not only quicker than the version equipped with the automatic transmission, the EPA estimates it will get 1 extra mpg on the highway. Manual transmission, 1, automatic, 0. We've devised our own fuel economy test in an attempt to replicate how most people drive on the highway. Our procedure entails a 200-mile out and back loop on Michigan's I-94 highway. We maintain a GPS verified 75 miles per hour and use the cruise control as much as possible to mimic the way many drivers behave during long trips. Despite EPA highway estimates within 2 miles per gallon of every rival, the Yaris we tested in our real-world testing was the only one to underperform. Its 34 miles per gallon observed was 2 less than advertised and 7 behind its top 3 competitors. The Yaris is an 11.1-gallon fuel tank that yields an estimated range of 370 miles, 60 miles less than the Honda Fit and 130 fewer than the Ford Fiesta we tested. A supple suspension and respectable agility help the Yaris escape the worst Econobox stereotypes. Although its abysmally slow acceleration and lack of steering feedback will not satisfy hot hatch enthusiasts, the Yaris can be pleasing to drive as long as speed is a low priority. Acceleration a peppy subcompact the Yaris is not. Our most recent test car was at least equipped with the standard 5-speed manual transmission, so it was faster than the 4-speed, insert grimace, automatic. Still, its 4-cylinder engine was loud when prompted for power and much slower than every rival we tested. Ride, handling, and steering the Yaris say had impressive ride quality for its class. It isolated harsh bumps well and suppressed minor pavement imperfections. However, road and wind noise intruded into the cabin at higher speeds due to thin glass and minimal sound deadening. The Yaris was stable around town and only leaned when pressed beyond the handling limits of typical owners. While the lower L&L trims were 15-inch wheels wrapped with all-season tires, the SE has 16-inch aluminium wheels with slightly wider versions of the standard rubber. Our tester posted 0.83 grams on our 300-foot skid pad, which is higher than most rivals and a decent number in general. Too bad the steering's uneven effort and non-existent feedback spoiled an otherwise above-average experience. Breaking the brake pedal in our SE test car, which is equipped with larger rear drum brakes than lower trims, had progressive feedback. While the last Yaris we tested had a long emergency stopping distance 185 feet, our most recent tester needed only 170 feet, shorter than the rest of this set.